when I woke up this morning, because I haven't written the whole thing, outline of what I want to do in the next big presentation across the big pond, but in looking at the diverse group, and like in the beginning there, it says, here's the beginning of your Bible, and there's the end of your Bible, right there. It says, the Lord thy God said, behold, the man had become like us, to know good and evil. And now, lest he put out his hand and take also of the tree of life, and eat and live forever. So everything in between, that in Genesis, and in the Revelation, a lot of people look at the Revelation as, you know, the end times, the second coming, and all the rest of the stuff they do. And it says, blessed are those who do his commandments. That's the key, doing the commandments. That they may have the right to the tree of life and may enter through the gates. That's the key phrase. And then he's talking about the outer world, the outer darkness, Plato's cave, whatever you want to call this realm here. But outside are dogs and sorcerers and sexually immoral and murderers and idolaters and whoever loves and practices a lie. So they're not all wiped out, but now you escaped Plato's cave. You escaped the outer darkness, and you are now in the city, in that inner reality, and with your true self. And when I was thinking this morning, and what came back when I began seeking, I began to explore my own previous lives, one of the things that really hit me that I did not really understand at the time. Remember, you don't have this merging of consciousness. It's like you're looking at the past events that you lived back then. It's not that you're this person or you're that person that you lived in the past, but you do have access into the storehouse, into your past lives. One of the things that took me a while to understand when I began looking into the Ebionite lives was that the elders were not expected to agree with each other on all things. And that one elder would be saying one thing, and another elder would be saying another thing within the scope of the Ebionite community itself. Also, what difference and what between our modern society, which I was raised, was that I was born an elder. They knew who I was, what I was before I was born. This was in the 4th century. I guess it was the end of the 3rd. But this was a concept that I had never been exposed to before in this life. There's all sorts of current concepts I was never exposed to in this life. But the idea that you could have this highly advanced spiritual community and there wasn't just one, there was no conformity. Like Amos's conversation today, oh, Apple's this and Google's this, and you need the diversity. Now, if we look at our diagram of the tree of life here, we have two columns. One is a feminine column, one is a male column. Of course, we understand, we've all been through this before, the bottom of the male column is logic and the bottom of the feminine column is intuition. But then we also have the earthly kingdom, which is feminine, and we have the heavenly kingdom, which is male. The division between these two is what is causing us to wander. Now, if we look at this, what we have to understand is that each one of these spheres, these 12 spheres, sees things entirely different than the rest. And this higher reality is built upon these 12 fragmented, valid truths that all existed within the construct of this higher truth. This is your Tower of Babel syndrome, where each of the spheres speaks a different language, and everything that they see is valid, but it's limited. Now here we have a table full of people. They're all mature spiritual seekers. That's why you're here. If you weren't sincere seekers in your past lives, then you wouldn't be here. You wouldn't waste your time. So you all have something to bring to the table. I'm here solely because of my wife. Because if I didn't have my wife, I would never have been able to develop to where I am today. So I was just as worldly, and I was a captain of the fire department, drank a lot, smoked a lot, did a lot, whatever. But then I came together with my wife, and that was one of the questions that I posed to my higher self in that time frame, was what, why me, and what makes you so sure that I can succeed in this mission that you're laying out to me? And it says, as long as they got me and my flow together, they were guaranteed success. And as I look back, my Flo's stepfather, who has passed away and whatnot, that was one of the impressions that I got, was back in the time of the Essenes, he was one of the leaders, great leaders. And they were always these leaders. But because they didn't understand the law of opposites, because the Essenes were known as the untouchables, they would not have anything to do with the rest of the crowds. And that was one of the big differences between the teachings of the way associated with the man Jesus and the Essenes. Why it's not just a thing off the Essenes. It's because the great diversity of truth and of thought that must come into play to nourish and form the tree of life. The tree of life is in the Genesis. And the tree of life is in Revelation. And everything in between is the developing of the mind and the spirit, bringing forth the fruit of the tree of life. And if I can impart something to a group such as this, it's what I learned when I first looked at the Essenes, and that the elders did not agree with each other. And here, in my way of thinking at the time, was that, well, the truth is one and absolute, so everybody must say the same thing, must see things. That's the exact opposite of finding truth. A woman should agree with a husband. The Iroquois Indians was probably one of the most advanced civilizations in that. And that the husband and wife only had one vote, and only the men voted, but he had to go get agreement from his wife before he could vote. And they had to come to peace within their own house, a decision with their own house before they could vote. Our culture today is trying to do everything it can to separate men and women, separate, demonize this group, demonize that group. And this is the way of ignorance. They could never restore what they had in the Ebionites. Because if Amos said something, well, that's what Amos says. And if Pete says something, well, that's what Pete says. Now, what truth do you find in what they are saying? This is an entirely different picture than what's painted by our culture today. We go to school, we get programmed, and this is this, and this is this, and this is right, and this is wrong, and whatnot. We know that the conservative voice is silenced in most of our universities. We know that unless you're a Muslim, this sect of the Muslim, that you're a heretic, and it's all right to kill you. We know that all these divisions within our culture, everyone, Flo and I used to go to various churches. And we used to hear them, the preacher preach, and it used to stimulate, and we used to see the fragment of truth that they had. And every group I've ever seen always has fragments of truth. And what we came away from it doesn't mean that they would agree with it, but we could see where they built a whole world, a whole mound of dogma around their fragment of truth. First time we went to a Quaker meeting in this life, we said, gee, we're Quakers. Trouble is, there wasn't any Quakers there. no real Quakers. Maybe there was two of the that had still had the spirit of Quakerism. The rest were all there for whatever. And we went to the Catholic Church, this church, that church. Like if I take a test online, whatnot, they say I'm some sort of, they probably will say I'm a Sufi, because they can't define what I am. And I can understand the Sufis. I can understand their spirituality. I can understand the Hasidic Jews. I can understand this group and I can understand that group. But because each one has got their organic limits, and they usually work from one sphere of the tree of life and they exclude all the rest, they cannot make any more progress than where they're at. But for a true seeker like ourselves, they're there to help us. And this I've explained in what I call the segmentation of mind. If someone is born, we're all born ignorant. We're all born unknowing. No matter what your spiritual DNA is, we're all born into this condition of ignorance. You can't help being born a man. Can't help being born a woman. Can't help being one point within that 144,000. But only by nourishing the mind, understanding what you see in the others and what's reflected, can you expand the consciousness. And can you begin to eat the fruit of the tree of life. Now, when I began regressing people into their past lives and actually exploring what they did, a lot of stuff I just wasn't prepared. There's nothing in our culture that prepared me to understand what they were saying, what I was observing. Taking people from a life to an after-death state, questioning them, what their perceptions over the life they were living. And it's all it was just so out of character with what our culture is and how we've been reared in this culture and our mindset, that most people today aren't even prepared to move beyond where they're at. Diversity is everything. But since most people censor, you hear men think women talk is crazy. You hear women think men talk is crazy. It's when they develop each other. What you make of your spouse, what you help in doing others. I watched Tony come, and Tony came and he's ready to go to work and help Beth. And I watched the people across the street when Bonnie and everybody had their whole property destroyed because of the ice, and everybody wants to do without any thought of charging or anything else because they could do. And they saw the need and they filled it. This is what mankind is supposed to be. And in all the successful civilizations throughout all the history that I've ever viewed and looked into, or regressed people into. There's some I didn't live in, but I regressed people into. This was always the case of the most successful, was they were willing to do because they saw the need, and they understood each person has something to say. Each sphere of the tree of life has its own unique vision of the world. Each of these visions is ultra important. When we talk about this, that's a whole different story than what people are accustomed to thinking. For a point, for a start, in my own interpretation, I see a point on the top, at the highest, most point. And the opposite of that point of the star, David, is all the way in the bottom, at the lowest, most point. And those two are opposites from each other. They belong together. If we look at the top horizontal, that's actually would be, holographically, that would be the spiritual. And we look at the bottom That's the physical. The problem is, when you're out of the body, that division in the spirit can only be resolved at the lowest point in the physical. And when you're in the physical, that division of the bottom can only be resolved by the top. But the way to get the top is through the bottom, through the reflection. So while you're in the physical, what you, instead of trying to be like meditating and denying the physical, what you want to do is you want to develop the physical so that it can join with the top. You want to join, you want to, the same thing with the left and the right and the inner and the outer. You want to bring the opposites together. This requires diversity. Requires looking at the opposites. And this is what they had, what the Ebionites had, what the Essenes were missing. There was diversity amongst the Essenes, but nothing like what came after the first century. They understood the laws and they understood that diagram right there. Most religions, they try, this is the truth, and it's the truth, but everything is made up of the sub-truths, and these must be brought together. When we created this constitutional form of government, we outlawed all interference with each individual opinion. Government was not allowed to interfere with a religious, a philosophical, or just because somebody wanted to do it. As long as you didn't hurt somebody else or impact somebody else, then you should have had the freedom to do it. Of course, that's all changed today. Now we have government demanding you wear a seatbelt, demanding you do this, demanding you do that, demanding everything, trying to control everything you do. So what we see now is we see the whole constitutional reality being put on a path of destruction. Same thing as the church, as the teachings, the original teachings of the way. As soon as government, as soon as an authoritarian rulers began to say, this is this, this is this, this is this, and this is what you allowed, that's the door to destruction. We see it right now with the United States. We saw it with the original teachings of the way. And it's something that the Ebionites did not have, because they did not even expect each elder to see things from the same perspective. There was no written book of dogma. It's like this morning, I was going to do what I was thinking of doing in England. Then the Spirit moved me to say, let me explain to them what I saw the first time I looked at the Ebionites in this life. Remember, it's not that I'm an Ebionite. I lived as an Ebionite. I accomplished oneness. I was a Buddha Ebionite, so was Flo, for that matter. But I'm not that right now, and when I first looked at it, it looked strange to me. I said, if the Ebionites had truth and there was these elders, why didn't they all agree with each other? They weren't expected to agree, because each one was born from a different perspective of the tree of life. And each one conveyed truths. It's like if the Gospel of Mary Magdalene, what Peter says, she says strange things. The Lord and Savior can't mean those things. Yes, she says strange things, because she's working from an opposite polarity that you are. And same thing with women. So if we take these 12 disciples, 12 tribes, 12 disciples, and pattern it in your own mind, this is what you have to bring together, and this is what you have to raise up in order to get escape Plato's cave, in order to escape out of the outer darkness. And unless we return to the constitutional foundation that this country was founded upon, where we have freedom of thought and freedom of diversity, true freedom. Admittedly, the constitutional framers could not give equal rights to all races across the gender divide, because that would have been just too big a step for the people at that time to take, mainly because we were dealing with ignorant Christians. Seriously, you don't think it was the Christians who said freedom of thought and everybody can think the way they want?
Of course not.
Do you think it's the Jews? I wouldn't last 2 minutes in one of these Jewish things. Kabbalah, you know, I told them the Kabbalah is nothing but a divine marriage manual. Get this dumb goyim out of here. What does he know? And the Christians will say the same thing. Like the post I put across James Trim's forum with the tree of life, with the key of knowledge. This is what it says. Now, the original Gospels used to say a lot of things like that. And when the authorities of the church, when they couldn't answer it, they just wiped them out, deleted them. And the way they went forward back in the second, third century was these are Gnostic interpolations. They went in there and wrote this bad stuff in our Gospels, so let's get rid of it. And you see the same thing in our colleges today. Condoleezza Rice couldn't speak at the college because somebody didn't agree with her. Same thing in another college. We're on the path of destruction. If gun control worked, Chicago would be Mayberry. Doesn't work. People, was it 14 people got murdered in Chicago? Strictest gun control laws in the country.
Was that last night?
That was 4th of July weekend.
Oh, 4th of July weekend.
I drove through the next day and didn't even know. Yeah. Not through Chicago. I think I said that to my daughter, too. I said, this is a bad place. We need to get out of here as fast as possible.
Yes.
And I didn't even know that means yet.
Yes. The moment you censor and you inhibit, it gets filled by a void, and the void is usually what you least expect. The Muslims are some of the most ignorant people in the world. They put their women in burqas. They kill whoever does not agree with them. And they're just pure ignorance. They accuse the Christians of corrupting the scriptures. That's true. They did corrupt the scriptures. But they never said, God wants you to kill whoever does not agree with you. Like
although
the Quran does.
Although they did kill heretics.
Huh?
The Catholic.
Not by the use of the scriptures. They
right.
did that because of their way of thinking, because their carnal nature. Remember,
so then
the first man to translate the Bible into a language that the people could use was William Tyndall. And for doing that, he got burnt at the stake.
Yeah.
As back in the 14th century, there was a priest named Peter. And I used to... One of the things I observed of that life was I used to do what secret masses, where I would translate the scriptures into the language that the people could understand. You weren't allowed to read the scriptures because the church did what they wanted to. But this wasn't Christian. This wasn't the teachings of Jesus. This wasn't the teaching of the way. This was the same thing as what you got now, Obama's interpretation of the Constitution.
Whatever
or Nancy Pelosi's or Rockefeller's Republicans or James Trim's idea of Jesus' teachings. Man corrupts. The United States was supposed to be a country where everybody would have the right to speak freely, to live as they wanted, There was some states where you had to take an oath to Jesus God. Think Maryland. That was acceptable. That was their community. Now you're not allowed to, if you try to rent a house and you only want to rent to a Christian, that's against the law. Look what Hobby Lobby just went through. They started this business to employ Christians and to try to hold a work environment. Working in New York City, I used to encounter the Hasidic Jews many times. And sometimes I get in conversation with them, since I had a yarmulke and a beard and whatnot. And many times I got into conversation with some of them. I said, how do you work for a company like New York Telephone? He says, well, it just happened that way. But I would have loved to be able to work for an employer that was open to my, at least some of my religious beliefs. So the idea that Hobby Lobby wanted to create an environment that closed every Sunday, same as Chick-fil-A, and it's a Christian-oriented environment. If you don't want a Christian-oriented environment, then you go get a job someplace else. But they tried to force them to do abortion pills. Where is the Constitution that would force them to violate their religious convictions? If you don't want to work for an employer that refuses to give you abortion pills or this, then you don't work for Hobby Lobby. Some people might want to work for them because they don't promote abortion. Taking the Little Sisters of Charity to court like the government has done, that's a sin upon sin. How can you force nuns who spend their life serving people to conform to our culture? The idea that you had to, that they homogenize. This is not the way a spiritual community can be built. It's not the way a marriage can be built. It's not the way any kind of true growth can be accomplished. The Constitution was imperfect. I can use the Constitution because you've never seen what the original Gospels looked like. You would be shocked to see what the pure Gospels looked like, with all the concepts and all the teachings that was in it that was removed or corrupted. Like when they removed the little children, for instance, what's a little child? But the Constitution of this country was an attempt to create an environment that would create exceptionalism. And it did. And you got the law of octaves right now is in the process of tearing it down. They're not tearing down the Constitution, they're tearing down the people's freedom. They're restoring chaos and despotism. And if I said to you, Hitler was reincarnated and he's now running for office in one of the parties, do you think that would promote a little fear in you, that what this guy would do when he gets a little power? Mm-hmm. That's what you got in all the world leaders. That's what you got. You got the despots of the past fighting the other side of the despots in the past, and the two groups wreak havoc upon the majority of people. You got church against church. You have, unless you understand the reason why men and women think opposite each other, why different groups think opposite each other, why each one sees things differently, you can make no progress. Now, myself and Flo, we think happily of the day we can move on to new horizons and get that. But this morning when I thought about what I would say, I said, the hell with this, I'll just keep working on this. I got another over a month to get this done. And what came to mind was the Ebonites. Remember, Flo, with the Ebonites, when we came to shock that each elder didn't say the same thing? How could this be? I had never seen such a thing before. Because I was brought up in a schooling system in this life that this is this, this is this, this is that. Either agree with us or you're wrong. The religion of America means you have the right to your opinion as long as you don't infringe on my rights, and I should fight to help you. Because only when you have the right to your opinion, do I have the right to my opinion. And only when each of us has the right. I don't have to agree with you. I don't even have to close my doors and have anything to do with you. But as an American, the religion of America is freedom and liberty. And to put into office the sad sack politicians that are in office right now, and most of them on both sides of the aisle, it's a scary proposition. I listen to Nancy Pelosi, and I can't believe that such people are such dingbats to listen to this woman, the garbage that comes out of her mouth. And they celebrate and they think, oh, this is great. Let's suppress. Let's not let Condoleezza Rice. Here you got, if you listen to the difference between Condoleezza Rice's speech that they had one time, they had a comparison, and Eric Holder's speech that he made at a university. You're talking night and day. Here you had a woman of intelligence, and here you had a man who is so ignorant that it's a shame that he's the Attorney General of the United States. One said, oh, you can't have freedom of thought, you can't have, we gotta suppress, we gotta exclude and censor. And the other one said, when I was a little girl, I couldn't go to a movie. But my parents said, you can grow up to be president. And she grew up to be Secretary of State. There you have one with the different visions. So should we suppress Eric Holder? No, but I think it's a bunch of fools to have him as Attorney General. But this is the case with most of the politicians that are leading. We've lost our standards. We've lost our we the people. And what freedom means. Here you have the image of freedom. And total agreement, because each vision has its place. And this is what you have to bring about within yourself. Each vision has its place. A pyramid is made up of many blocks that form it. Now how about opposite pyramids in harmony with each other? There you have it. Do we have any thoughts or questions? Everybody's traveled a long way to get here. Cooking's not all that great.
Not too bad.
One quick question.
What's that?
Since you mentioned the Hitler thing, do we get a clue?
So who Hitler is? I don't know.
You don't know? I thought maybe you did. Okay.
But
you're just using that
here as
an example.
Yeah, they're always all. Read history. Read about the despots. That's who's on the stage right now. Not in the same personality. I'm not the same personality I was when I was an Ebonite. Not the same personality I was in the first century. I'm not the same person I was when I was known as the saint.
But would there be certain key?
Yes, it's my spiritual DNA.
They would bring in, like, that you could personally recognize that this is like
they're patterns of.
They stay in the same
patterns.
And you can see it.
Well, you know, when we first started talking about Obama 6-7 years ago, I started looking at those patterns, the lines that you had revealed, and it was like, oh, he's still doing those things.
Yes.
Because he hasn't learned his lesson.
No.
So he's still having to repeat
the question things. Is, have the American people learned their lesson?
No.
So then when they're born under a Stalin or a Fidel Castro and they say, my goodness, why God doesn't love me? What am I doing here? Because you were given the opportunity and you didn't.
You squandered it.
And this is how the prodigal son learns.
Well, I also think, you know, that a lot of those people that were born in the Soviet Union and died, and, well, I wish I had freedom. Now they're here and they're squandering their life.
Yes.
Now they have it.
What does it say in the previous one? He who does my commandments, do not judge, yet discern. Understand. My Savior, in all my past lives, has always been, because I always wanted to know why. And, you know, why does a woman see things differently than I do? Why does this man see things differently than I do? Why is this? Why is that? It's that hunger for understanding why that has always been my source of development. When I saw the Ebionites and I said, and I saw that this one was saying things that was in distant group that was, that Matthew would have found contrary. And Matthew said, oh, that's nice. Why? Why didn't they say, this is right, and this is wrong, and this is this, and this is that? Because each of those 12 spheres sees things from a different perspective.
We all had to be there in order to have the whole.
Yes, in order to escape the limitations. Man without woman is dead. That's the forbidden fruit of the tree of duality. He who eats the tree of the fruit of duality dies. They're already dead. The Gnostics, some of the Gnostics say, well, the God of the Jews is evil because he separated Adam and Eve. Most people don't understand that. Of course, the separation was necessary. That's why the second day of Genesis is the only day that said it wasn't good, because duality, though necessary, is what causes all the trials and tribulations and suffering in the world. Now the question is, how long will you go and be subject to this suffering, the trials and tribulations, before you change? Can't expect the world to change, because world never changes. If it did, they'd have to invent a new world just to replace this one. When you get down right down to it, it's understanding and living by the golden rule, and understanding what you see is what the secret is to that tree of life. I find the New Age, lots of them, full of all sorts of good wisdom and whatnot, but because the people themselves don't live and don't think about it, they just squander away their opportunity, and so is all the churches. If I look out at the world, all I see is fragments of truth that I'm going to agree with. I just don't agree with their dogma that they create around that fragment. They take a little piece of truth and they say, this is the whole thing. And everybody who doesn't agree with it, well, we won't listen to it. We'll kill it. We'll censor it. We'll do this. We'll do that. You know, the liberals have great insight into what they're saying. All the children of the world should be helped. But how do we help them? And as far as this country, it goes back to that statement of JFK in his inauguration. Ask not what you can do for this nation, but ask not what the nation can do for you, but what you can do for the nation. The people we let in here should be willing to come here because it's an environment of growth and development. People in this room should be here because it's an environment of growth and development, not because the food tastes good or the company tastes good. or whatever. And it goes back to what the original Essenes and what the difference I saw. To tell you plainly, Flo will tell you, in the life in the first century, I didn't like the Essenes. She was an Essene. So I made an excuse for her. I had been born in Essene, but I had abandoned them. And it's because of their untouchable ways and their aloofness that I didn't like. That was their failure. The Ebionites were in somewhat the same way, but as Matthew, I used to travel all over the Roman Empire dealing with these groups, that group, and whatnot, and helping them wherever I could, and I traveled far and wide. Same as I do today. I write. I have one of the few unmoderated forums going. Like this JJ who's now come into our life. Everything has to go through the moderator. As long as on this forum that I run, as long as people behave and they don't get obnoxious like Chad, or I'm a Hebrew and whatnot, and they don't get vulgar and whatnot, then we'll listen to whatever they have to say and I'll answer them. Most of them go away because they can't reply back to me at a certain point. Because they're so narrow in their thinking. And that's what you have to do to succeed. Everybody has something to say. Women can be the hardest creatures to understand in the world, from a man's perspective. And men can be the simplest creatures to deal with in the world from a woman's perspective. This is what happens when you have opposites dealing with each other. But your success, a woman's success, is what she can make her husband into. How she can bring success to her husband. And the success of a man is how he can help a woman to develop all those crazy ideas she has into a higher truth. But since few people understand the merger of opposites, they could never understand that Star of David overlaid over the 12th sphere tree of life. And all that it tells and all that it conveys. It's all these harmonized opposites coming together to create this higher truth. That's called Yeshua, the higher truth, that condition of mind. There it is. You have to bring about that within yourself. Now, I just traveled a long way to get here. How can I answer your questions? And she didn't even want to ride with Robert.
On the motorcycle.
They both came from Canada down to here, and I don't understand why Angie didn't want to ride.
Why didn't you want to ride 1,000 miles on a motorcycle?
Yeah, in record time.
Yeah, at the speed of light.
It's hard to understand.
Beth has moved here, and as far as I'm concerned, the light of God has shone on her. So, how can I answer any questions? How can I be of help to you?
Something I heard you say today, and I'm not sure I've seen it written that way, or maybe I just missed it, is harmonized opposites.
Harmonized opposites can only be done, see that triangle?
Mm-hmm.
So there you got the bottom horizontal, there you got the opposites. And when the third force has the same angles coming up, that's how you get to the higher plane.
Mm-hmm. And it's about not negating either.
You can't negate either. each part has to fit together like it's supposed to.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is that you also have the opposite polarity between spirit and what we call flesh. And again, if the division is here, it's only because the same division exists in spirit. And what's in the earth is only a reflection. Now, it may not be that case within my soul, because my soul has a long history, going back further than I could even think of. And my soul has developed. So, over a course of a number of lives, that's what it looks like. And some of the people here also. You're here for a reason. You could be out playing golf, like Obama or whatever you do. Drinking. Today's Sabbath. Barbecue. But you're here. And there's something within each person here that's motivating that they're here. Kelsey doesn't know that she was motivated before she entered into this life to marry Sean. It was all planned. Now what you do with this opportunity, that's up to you. Everybody else, you're here. This is an opportunity. Can you just come together and work and bring together each one of the skills, the opposites, and merge and create the higher reality? Can you do this with your children? Each one of us entered this world ignorant. How are we doing, how are we helping our own children that they have better than we? Are we sending them to dance school and be programmed by the culture which is based upon Darwinism? It's amazing how far modern physics has come, yet they still teach the theory of evolution. It's like I get amazed when you show people that there's six, in addition to the ancient scriptures, there is six independent pre-Nicene church fathers who all quote their Bibles and all state that the word spoken to Jesus at the baptism was, "Today I have begotten thee." And they're in denial. Total denial, because it does not compute, and they choose to stay with their dogma. Same thing as the church that called itself Orthodox. Oh, that can't be right in the scriptures. It must be a Gnostic interpolation. It was admitted by a number of biblical scholars that they've never found a Gnostic interpolation, and that all the interpolations were all the insertion of the doctrine of the Trinity. Jesus is God. That's all the, you know. People are incapable of thinking outside their box. They have that right. And that's what this country was supposed to be. Was everybody has a right. If you own a house and you only want to rent to Christians, that should be your right. As long as the government doesn't force people to do against what they want, unless it infringes on somebody else's rights. If I don't want to wear a seatbelt, then what right do they tell me I have to wear a seatbelt? If I didn't always have my head covered, they'd run into trouble with the helmet laws. If you go across the border into South Carolina, you could take your motorcycle helmet off. I've been driving a motorcycle for 50 years. I never once needed a helmet. What if, maybe it's valid, but when you put yourself in a burqa, you inhibit your growth and development. And the government is always trying to control the people with shackles. The church maintained control over the people by maintaining the people in shackles. It's against the law in an Islamic country to be anything but what the leaders say you're supposed to be, or else they'll behead you in the town square. If a young girl gets raped, they put a stoner to death. They don't tell you that there's good reason that Arafat died from AIDS because he was having sex with little boys. And that's what they've been keeping secret about Arafat. All this stuff goes on behind the scenes. This country was supposed to be create exceptionalism because the people who started it, who authored the Constitution, all understood the reason for diversity of thought. They didn't understand like I understand today, because they had a job to do and they did the job to get it done. But they understood the principles of what's there on that screen. And if I bring this into one of our colleges or higher learning, they couldn't interpret that regardless of how long you gave them or what it means. Yet these people are censoring and demanding that others adhere to their ideas. And like Condoleezza Rice, if they don't agree with her, then they won't let her speak. It wasn't this case amongst the Ebionites. Against all truly advanced spiritual communities. It wasn't supposed to be that way in this country. And I believe you're on the path of destruction from what I see. Again, I'm entertaining any questions whatsoever. Kelsey, you got any? Does this sound like a bunch of craziness or what?
No.
Huh?
Alright.
You doing all right?
Yeah. I don't know how well they had a problem with it, but I think I've been hearing it.
Mary?
Any
thoughts about what I said?
I see it as like a unity coming together. Like you were saying, like the I guess you would say like the negative and the positive.
I'm really saddened that women haven't really demanded to be free. To be free to work. And in some ways, the New Age has.
Yeah, that has opened up, I will say, yeah.
But because they have no restraint, because they lack clear vision, they just manufacture ideas as quickly as it comes in their head. So they're missing the male part. And the men that they have, most of them are just go along with whatever.
True, that's true.
I never understood about the New Age, how they could have all this insight into the indigenous religions, the animal natures that they control and everything else. And they didn't put two and two together to say, hey, I have this within myself.
That's why it makes me feel like there's a balance. You have to have the balance.
Yes, you do.
Well, and that's why I was thinking that we escape.
The answer is not with women.
Right.
The answer
right.
is not with men.
Exactly. Yeah.
The answer is not with a linear perception. The answer is not with an intuitive perception.
Yeah.
Or the answer is not with meditating and having head sex. The answer is in wholeness. And wholeness, that's the image of wholeness right there. Now you travel all this way and you're going home with Robert?
Yeah.
No?
No.
Both come from Canada. So this morning I got the feeling that I shouldn't try to do, which I've been working on. And who knows, when I get to England, I may not even do it then.
Surprise!
Yeah. We're talking about America and Constitution.
Huh?
We're talking about America and Constitution.
I was going to write an article on the Thomas Paine one, that old Tommy's returned to England and they don't know it. They said, if anybody could bring him back here, we'll chop his head off as soon as we get hold of him. Why? Because I said there was no such thing as a royal bloodline, and that everybody's equal. Such a concept they couldn't deal with. They've been having this secret order since the first century, where Prince Charles thinks of himself as the offspring of Jesus. Yeah, that's right. And you know who wrote about that? Old Thomas Paine. And for that, they convicted him in absentia, and they said, if we get him, you can shoot him on sight. Because he said, there is no royal bloodline, and we're all brothers and sisters. It's a lot I don't like that Tommy wrote, but I understand him. There's some things I don't agree with that some of the church writings that survived, but I understand that they were written for their time. So now it's a different time, and probably all those personalities will be wide-eyed and say, how could he write the things I write now? But it's a different time. And you have to be cognizant of the time you're in and do the best you can with it. But if you understand the diversity and you have that hunger for truth and knowledge, then you'll succeed and you'll overcome. It's the hunger for knowledge. And most often, those who you disagree with the most will have something valid to say to you. You may not agree or think like they do, but they have a valid truth. Each of those horizontal lines all possess a valid truth, an opposite, and all a half of each other. And that's one of the things I couldn't understand when I first became introduced to the Ebionites. I had never heard of Ebionites before. I'd never heard of half the concepts that I encountered when I began to be exploring these past lives, or regressing other people into past lives. Whoever wanted to be regressed, I would regress. Let's see what we can see. And I came to all sorts of things that I had never thought about before, never been exposed to before. And that's how you develop, through the opposites. And while you may disagree initially, if you keep working on it, you keep struggling with trying to do it, the answer will come to you. Beth, questions?
I know you kind of diverted. You're not doing the London thing today.
I don't know what I'm going to do in London.
The London thing doesn't exist in a way, I guess. But what you had originally planned to do there, just the highlights. Like, if someone were to walk away from that, what are two or three things you would like that they at least listen? I mean, I don't want to divert things completely.
No, that's all right. It's your day.
When are you going to London?
The end of August.
No, the premise of that connection between
the findings of physics, and is that how you got invited to this? I'm trying to remember how you got invited. Or was it?
One of the organizers read your website?
I'm known all over the world. People read my websites. They, you know, I have a bunch of unique things. Unlike most people, I strive to prove whatever I say.
Mm-hmm.
And I always give often a multifaceted answer to whatever I say. And as far as I'm concerned, and I've gotten that, like I could never sit down and write a book from start to finish over all the things that, because I think like I do. And this is who I am, and this is what I am. And that's fine. My higher self likes me just the way I am. So does my wife. So what more do I want? But because I ran an unmoderated forum, and I had every activist in the world come to try to prove they were right, this made me delve into all sorts of things that I could now take it from, take my what I was writing from virtually any position. So I saw this in my past lives. Now I can cheat, because I know who in history, or I can easily find out who in history agrees with that and who was against it. Now I knew Origen. The original Origin, I knew this one, I knew that one, and I could bring this all together and prove my points. Nobody's really ever done that, because they always start off on the premise that they're right and everybody else is wrong. Now, I can't say that I didn't think I was right, but there was a whole lot of effects that I was missing. And everybody that asks questions always brings to me a unique perspective. And it's that unique perspective that enables me to mold my words and mold what I'm saying in a different way. Like Dina said, I get repetitive. That's true, but I also use links to explain things.
Mm-hmm.
This links, hyperlinks are a whole new world. I mean, if I had hyperlinks back when, who knows what I would have done. And lots of times when I set a hyperlink, it's because I want to focus in on a certain thought.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes I have to lay a small foundation in there. A thought, a human is a complex being. The intelligent mind is made up of volumes of lesser thoughts and realities that bring you to this point, the developed mind. You can't eliminate all this down here and still have up here. You can't start eliminating the bottom blocks of a pyramid and still have the top with the eye. So everything has to be in balance. And like JJ's form, I was looking at that, and you could, if you want to look, let me see what we got here. Here's our form. I've been monitoring JJ's form to see what he does. But, oh, they got some posts. But if you look down here at the form settings, what is it about? And this is what you find in most of them. Here's your group description. It's got 444 members. He's under New Age. Down here, messages require approval. That means every message that gets posted to that forum requires approval by one person or a small group of monitors.
Censorship.
Yes, it is. Now, if you come over here and you look at our main forum,
about his writings.
About Is it on about? No. Yeah. Messages from new members require approval. In other words, if I have somebody join the forum, I want to know that they're there for good reason. I don't want them cursing on the forum. I don't want them saying Jews are this, or this one is that, or using foul language. So until I become comfortable with them, then I will monitor them. But here, all members can post. That means you, Pete, when you make a message and you have an opinion, nobody has to sit there and say whether they'll let this through or not. When you post, here's the members. In case you've never seen management, you don't have this screen on here. I do. Manage members. See all these, those allowed there?
Mm-hmm.
That means they can post freely whatever they want to say. You don't have that in the other forums. And that at times has been a real pain in the ass when you get people like Chad,
yeah,
all the people who thought they were the Messiah,
mm-hmm,
or all the people that thought they were born again. But each time that they came here to do battle with me, I got into their way of thinking and developed answers to them. It's not that I didn't think I was right, but there was explanations that I was lacking that all goes into the equation of why. All that branching out into that pyramid, that foundation. And by running an unmoderated forum like that, this is how these writings have become so diverse and so in-depth.
I think also what it's, at least for me, is with letting Chad, I'm a Hebrew, and these others in sometimes, is you, it allows you to see these other patterns.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the time it's circular.
I never took the red heifer seriously.
Yeah, I know.
Or the spiritual Essene.
Yes. The
spiritual BDSM.
Yes. But their arguments are concerned, like with Chad, every time he comes back, it's like a different personality in his past.
That's true too.
Peeks through and allows us to go, okay, where's that personality come? Which one, you know, where we finally pin out, oh, you must have been one of those that persecuted us in the such and such century.
But it's also in exploring their perception,
mm-hmm,
that you grow
you
and
can
you
reach
deepen
that
yourself.
Part of yourself.
Yeah. And go past it. That's
like
the key.
You know, when first started exploring with my wife Flo, and I said, well, tell me. She said, I can't tell you. This is what I feel. Said, for my perception, that's thoroughly frustrating. What do you mean you can't tell me? Well, what do you mean you have this feeling?
Feel it.
It just is. You know?
Exactly. Why
the goddess has spoken. Now what do I do? And that, from a male, from my perspective, that was thoroughly frustrating. And if I got upfy about it, then she'd get mad at me, and then life would be hell.
Happy wife, happy life.
Yes. So I had to take all these pieces that she would come up with, or the impressions that she would have, and then I'd have to go and explore myself and make sense of them. And it wasn't that they were wrong. Sometimes they were lacking in things. It's like the New Age. It's lacking in stability. It's lacking in wholeness. It's got all these pieces out there of all these perceptions and no unity, no real higher vision.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that they're wrong. It's just they're all fragmented and all over the place.
That's kind of a reflection of each one of us.
Now, you see the difference between JJ's forum, where somebody only what agrees with JJ or his handful of mine. And this is the same way with Trim. This is the same way with all these. You go on a Christian forum and post some of the stuff there. Oh, the original gospel said Jesus was a man who became the anointed. They'll throw you off so quick, they'll censor you. Who are they censoring? All they're doing is chaining, shackling themselves, putting themselves in a burqa, if you'll have it. We don't have that here. And when you say you lived as the brother of Yeshua, and you get all these ideologues out there. I got to go prove him a fraud. Got to go prove him wrong. Those who have been there for any length of time can see that. I've observed it. And that, I must admit, at times been frustrating, but this is how all these web pages got ripped. That's why they go into such depth and detail. Why can't two men be the same as two, and as a man and a woman? Well, there's a whole lot of reasons why. Give me a jar of sperm and a jar of ovum and see what happens to them. Shake them up, do whatever you want, what happens? Nothing. Well, that's what you got there in that tree of life. You want the tree of life back? That's fine. Ah, no, we got know thyself. She asked me to stop in the beginning.
But everything you said, Alan, like different religions, different things, everybody having their own point of view that is relevant in some way, I would imagine the same thing happens within one person.
Yes.
Because I know from
myself,
what
I've got
is so
all
many
about
different
observing.
Voices, so many different, depending on, I don't know, stimulus or whatever.
Yes.
And some personalities I can actually see progressing, excelling, you know, kind of like, there, yeah, go, go, go. But then I've noticed that there, I've got voices, I've got personalities that would sooner stomp me to the ground than see me succeed kind of thing. And it's like,
mm-hmm.
You know, like, I wish you guys would just homogenize, you know, just come together a little
work,
bit.
Doesn't work like that.
No, it's, and it's difficult at times.
Well, that's
like
a good assessment.
With your own personalities,
yeah.
It's like, every day you wake up, it's like, okay, which one of you is going to deal with today?
Notice Gurdjieff is not very popular amongst the New Age, because he paints a too complex picture for them to comprehend it. Same thing, they really can't. Well, back in, let's say, the personalities of Pythagoras and whatnot, they just kept secret teachings, more or less. They didn't publish like I have here. And mainly because the majority of the people were uneducated, they couldn't even begin to explain higher reality. When Paul writes that, if I spoke plain to you, you'd think I'm a nut. He was serious. We are a being of light. Isn't that what it says there? Know thyself. We, each of us, is a being of light. And these bodies are just vehicles, allegorical vehicles.
Oh, I think outside of this room, if I had said something like that, they'd put me in psychiatry. I'm hearing these. I'm aware of all these different voices, you know, and they're different. It's like, okay, yeah, this is the only place I could say something like that and actually be understood.
Yes, and that's important. That's why we run an unmoderated forum. If Kelsey wants to come and say, you're all full of shit, she has that ability, if you remember. And we've seen that a bunch of times. And we don't react by censoring them. We react by saying, what is your problem? Let's hear your vision of reality. And then we take them apart.
Where are you coming from?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But we don't, same as JJ, why his people is not even, only a few of them are prepared to even read our forms. It's because everything has to go through the moderator. Why, James Trim? Oh, we can't allow that in. This last post I made to him about the key of knowledge, he has absolutely no answer for it.
No.
And I'm relying upon the literal text of the gospel, what's left of it. And he can't deal with what's left of it after the census. There's your second one. You like it? Did I do a good job with it?
Very nice.
Reality of the soul self. We are a being of light in our natural state. We're not a woman. We're not a man. We're not black. We're not white. We're not a nationality. There is no religions.
No language.
No. It's all impressions. Thought impressions. And in the realm of souls, there is sex, or a type of sex, the joining of the light, being with lights. And when I first got
that from somewhere, I don't know, I kind of got it from somewhere where the light merged, you know.
They can.
Weird.
So do you and Flo know each other in your soul and
yes.
Flo's soul?
And others. But I'm on a mission, and they sometimes things get excluded to me. And they do exclude because they're in control. You're being guided. You're here for a reason. What are you going to do with this opportunity? The more you embrace the opportunity, the more you develop, the more you'll receive. The soul has no gender, race, or body. Soul cannot incarnate into the body. Why can't the soul incarnate into the body? This is a three-dimensional world. There's no way the soul, which has existed since the dawn of time and has within it all the personalities, can incarnate into the body. You can transform the body where the soul can become an integral part of it, your true self, but not at any time in organic man. At conception, an embryonic image is projected into the body. One point out of 144,000 in the diagram of the tree of life. How can you fit the gigantic and the sublime soul into one point? The physical birth is the first of four stages of birth. And you really can't make quadruple spiritual gains until you become your true self. What does the gospel say? A house that is divided cannot stand. A marriage where there's not unity, and husband and wife is not a marriage, no matter what man says. We emerge from our mother's womb as a cosmic ovum, a sperm. Holographic. What does a holographic image mean? It means that each fragment contains within itself the image of the whole. So your body was formed through the merger of the sperm and egg. When it comes into this world, it's just the sperm and egg of the next level, and so on, until it gets to be one with the Logos, as what Jesus was. A holographic divine pattern means that the macrocosm is replicated into all the pieces of the microcosm. This is why Gurdjieff said about the tree of life, about the scriptures, he that has the capacity can work it out for themselves. Why? Because all they have to do is understand what they see. Gee, Gospel Thomas says that. Understand what you see, and everything will be revealed to you. When you understand this as the reality, that what you're seeing is a microcosm of the macrocosm within, and you're part of the bigger picture, and all that exists in the outside world also exists within you, then you can easily come to terms with it.
And that's where I was getting at this physics stuff, because they're getting at that point in physics. Where they're
yes, they
that,
are.
That
physics
what
is
what
left.
You're seeing is created in your own mind.
Physics has left most science so far behind that it's becoming a cult. Pythagoras will be born as a physicist and get along just fine. And they'll look at the rest of these people who say they're scientists and say, what a bunch of duds. The hologram strengths and weaknesses, and this is important to understand. The very fact that a hologram is an image of a higher reality means that you can mistake its strengths, its weaknesses, that you can confuse what you see with the all of reality. The deist says let's look out. We can look at creation and we can see God. We can see the signature of God. And we can do this for the use of reason and intellect, something which most Christians reject, most religious people reject. Yet the atheist also looks at the outside world, and he doesn't see God at all. He says it's running without God. There is no God. There is only what you see. So which one's right? Both.
Partially.
One has a very limited, one is fooled by the image of the hologram. Everything looks complete in the out in this world, yet the modern physicist tells you that it's a blemish in the intersecting forces of the field, and that what you're seeing is only the tip of the iceberg, the cosmic iceberg. So now you have to develop the ability to see beyond these limitations. Isn't that what the Bible's all about? Or at least of what I've written, what I've portrayed. So I write, the strengths are seen in the fact that if you understand the pattern in the physical, then you can apply this knowledge to all levels of being. The Gospels are written so they can be used by anyone. And that's the advantage of a hologram. You're going to prevail at your level. And then you will find you're now entered the next level until you get to the top. But once you understand the pattern, you can prevail over each level. You can pull yourself up on the next rung of Jacob's ladder. And the weaknesses is seeing the fact that the sub-holographic reality artificially appears complete. And this is the limited vision of the atheist in comparison to the true deist, who says, I can look at the world around me, I can use reason and intellect, and I can see God and I can see all things. Where the atheist, he only sees the limitations of this physical illusion, and he says nothing else exists. But in so doing, he has to deny a whole lot of things, a whole lot of ideas that people have, a whole lot of perceptions that people have. If a little child of 4 or 5 years old can tell of a past life with such accuracy that they can prove it, the atheist will say it must be some sort of illusion. I don't have an answer, so it doesn't exist. They're so in denial of it doesn't exist, the same thing as a Christian who looks at the read, who tries to deny that the Bible has been corrupted. How can anybody read the article on Bible corruption and say, oh, it's perfect?
That one got me.
Well, their answer that I used to get was, well, God is all-powerful, and he knows everything from beginning to end, so he knew that the Bible was going to be written that way, and if he didn't want it that way, it wouldn't be that way.
That's true.
And
he also knew that
if, rationalize
he
it.
Also knew that a corrupted people, an organic man who was incapable of comprehending higher reality, needs dumbed-down scriptures in order to be at least get on the path. We can speak a common language. The Bible teaches a common language that we can communicate. Notice there's very few atheists, so people start off atheist amongst us, because they never learned the common language. We can use the scriptures and the gospels and the sayings in the gospels and convey great thought or great depth. An atheist can't do that. It doesn't make sense to them. Nothing makes sense to them. So in other words, for the common man to be molded by these teachings, there had to be the common language developed. As Matthew, the 4th century Ebionite, entered into that life to ensure that the scriptures were preserved. It's not an accident that Dead Sea Scrolls were found in about the same time frame as the Nakamani Library. It's not an accident. That was orchestrated.
And the restoration of Israel as a nation.
If the Israel did not win the Seven-Day War, the Dead Sea Scrolls would have remained under the control of the church and they still would not be published. But because when they came under the controls of Israel instead of the Palestinians, the church lost their control over it. And that's why we know as much as we know, and there's still stuff they're not saying.
There's still a lot of stuff in the Vatican that...
Oh, the Vatican is loaded.
It's loaded.
That was one of the powers of Helena Blavatsky, but she was a psychic. And the story goes that one day some bishop confronted her and he says, how could you say these negative things about Christianity that you're saying? And she turned and looked for him and began, I guess, psychically looking into the archives of the Vatican. He says, here I see this. How could you be lying to the people about what's in that library and not turning over and not telling them what's in there? And it's almost like the Catholic Church, if you read the Mary Knoll, one thing that shocked us, remember that flow? And we asked about it in spirit.
That one.
In the Mary Knoll Catholic Dictionary, it says, it defines truth. And it says, truth is one and absolute. And then in parentheses, not necessarily explicit and declared. And they think that the truth belongs to them.
Yeah.
And that whatever's in the Vatican Library belongs to them and not with everybody else. They're the keepers of the truth because they look upon themselves as Christ's church. And the other people have no right to it. And this was something, when we came across this, we explored and researched it. And
but that's like a whole world of starving people, and you've got a vault full of bread, and we're not giving it to you because we're keeping it for ourselves. It's just...
That's the way they think.
Yeah.
It's the same as that Prince Charles concept, of the bloodline of Christ.
What was it on? You said that Catholics had the truth and the Protestants, you could go to...
The Catholics were afraid of history because it showed their corruption. So if you wanted to know about history, you always went to Protestant sources. Because the Protestants said, well, we got rid of all that garbage at the Reformation, so they don't care. The more they portray the actual events of history, the more they to their liking, because they were concerned that the all they need is the Bible. Now, if you want to know the inconsistencies and the stuff in the Bible, then you went to the Catholics or church, because they didn't go by the Bible.
So they didn't care.
Yeah, I was used to go to atheist websites to find like all the little paradoxes and whatnot. Is it
that book about the 11th edition of the Encyclopedia Britannica is truly enlightening. What used to be in what they call the scholar's edition of the Encyclopedia Britannica, because it told the truth about history. And as soon as they tried to move the Britannica out across the world, out of England, the Catholic Church opposed them and did everything they could to politically block them until they took away the truth that was written in there about history. And even the truth that they reported, a lot of it was whitewashed, but it was better than other sources. Most scholars are agnostic at best, and most of them are atheist. That's their job. The ordinary believers, you know, they can't say too much, because or else they'll get run out and they'll lose all their money and their funding.
Same with the doctors with near-death experiences who have had patient after patient who have come back and said things that were impossible. for them to know, and they can't talk about it.
That was the toughness lens, hon. We were talking about the chiropractic adjustment of my son Jacob when he was young. They thought he was going to die. He was so bad, and our chiropractor, that was a toughness lens. Our chiropractor felt that his whole energy flow in his body was totally off and wrong. And every time he tried to adjust them, he'd just go right out of adjustment again. And they had this, he had this friend who had what they call a toughness lens. And they could see the microwave loss in the body, and they adjusted Jacob using this toughness lens. And after they did that, Jacob was cured, at least his problems that he was born with. Mm-hmm. The toughness lens basically is unknown today because the FDA stopped them. I think they even prosecuted Dr. Toughness, who developed it, because they couldn't, it was too far advanced, it was, you know, you could eliminate a lot of stuff, it wasn't pushing drugs and the stuff that medical science, the witchcraft of medical science has been promoting.
Well, how do you spell
it? That it cured, you know, he couldn't pee, he couldn't do a bowel movement, he was extremely jaundiced, he couldn't swallow. You know, there was a whole, I can't even think of everything. It was like a list this long. And the office was about 15 minutes from our house. And by the time I got home, you know, his color was good. He did a poo, which he had never done. Uh-huh. And he started peeing. Eat, drink, you know, nursing.
That's when he was a baby.
This was after they used this, they adjusted him for a couple of hours, they worked on him.
Yeah.
Because every time they tried an adjustment, it'd go out, but then they used this lens to read the microbiotic levels that his body was like twisting up inside of him. But that toughness lens does not exist today because the FDA won't let it be used.
It circumvents modern medicine. Yeah.
If your body is in alignment, you don't need the physicians and the drugs and everything else.
Well, that's why they've been fighting against chiropractic.
Well, some chiropractors are you know, everything.
Some are better than others.
Yeah.
Some of them are better than others, and some of them are frauds, and some of them are whatever. But you get this in everything.
But you know, when you mention this thing, I think about something that Larry had said a while back, that it was like a remembering, that this toughness lens, it wasn't the first time that existed. It's like something similar to that one existed in the past to do a similar thing to people that needed it. And it just came back, and the same thing that had happened before, it got suppressed.
So it was like something, one of those things in Star Trek or something where they go,
it is popping out of the future.
Back in Atlantean times, we look back there, and they used to actually cure Down syndrome. And they did so by some way projecting the body into the crystal, into these crystals they had. And they healed the primary cell. The original one where the sperm and the egg came together. That's the primary cell. Mm-hmm. And once they healed that primary cell, all the rest fell into place. And they actually healed Down syndrome. We can't do today what we could do back then because it was a different age. Mm-hmm. They had personal flying machines back then. The beach had golden sand on it. It was an entirely different environment. People were using different aspects of their mind. And we could never do what we did back then because it was a different time frame. So this is why I said you got to do the best you can in the lifetime you're in the now. But you can learn from all that within your past. The only limitations you have on you is the ones you place upon you. And most of the times because of censorship. self-imposed limitations. Where was I? We did deism versus atheism. We covered that. Now we're back to the tree of life.
See, it's all.
I've already gone way past my time allotted in England. I only got to what, 2 hours for?
You're one and a half, or in the fourth half hour.
I thought this was one of the better talks.
Was it? That's because I dumped it all to start with. Every time you put a linear limits on things, then you end up losing something in the thing. And
I have the same problem with teaching. If I try and organize my classes, it's so much trouble to prepare a class schedule, like what I'm going to do in 45 minutes. I couldn't do it.
Well, my administrators hated me because I've never turned in a lesson plan.
There's a time and a place.
I turn it up and I go on and do something completely different.
There's a time and a place for linear application. But the linear has to meet the opposite in order to be complete, and it has to evolve higher. In the image we see here, with down in the earth, that's the bottom horizontal right there with the opposite, right there. Just meeting together means that the third force is on the same horizontal plane. That has to be, the third force has to be evolved. It's like a marriage. The coming together of male and female is just the beginning. It has to be developed. It has to be nurtured. It has to be grown to where you exist on a higher plane and transforms the people involved.
So there's a central column in the tree of life. I still don't get...
It's all in the center, right? Actually, it's all in that one, the second one from the top. That's out of place. But there's no way I can draw it.
So is that... Okay.
That belongs around all the rest. And when that wise man back then said, faith without works is dead, that's the center of the works right there, that one below the top one. Because all the rest work through that. And it's what you do that makes the difference. And intellect, we call that the intellect sphere. If we went back and we could see that, when these go to, we'll go through it. That one that says intellect there, it's out of place. That should be evolved around all the rest, because it's what you do with what you know. It's what you accomplish with the truth that's given to you that makes the difference.
So the center column spheres.
That connects.
Connects.
Brings it all together. And it's all right there in the center.
Between left and right.
See the love sphere right there in the center? Love is all the 11, all in harmonized together. And that's your answer. And it's got to be in the practice. You can never possess any greater truth than you are willing to live and manifest.
So the center ones, actually, like you said, the intellect surrounds all of them.
Yes.
So in other words, the problem with drawing the tree of life is that you can't draw it in the correct dimension.
Not in a linear way.
It's more dimensional.
The trouble is we don't see in dimensions. And even that tree of life, that has branches off dimensionally. That's a haphazard way there.
Makes me think of an egg. How the intellect would be the outer shell and everything is inside the yolk. And the,
yes.
You know, it makes me think of an egg that...
You got to take all, in order for you to succeed, you have to remove all limitations from yourself. And you have to be willing to develop yourself.
Which are mostly self-imposed as well.
Now JJ, we showed you the form of JJ, it doesn't even conceive to him that maybe I should just allow people to express themselves, because he doesn't have an answer to everything. Actually, he's pissed at me somewhat.
But didn't he just post that he wanted the two forums to
interact?
Yes, he
did. But that's what he said.
But it sounded like he wanted your forum to be more New Age, where anyone could talk about.
I have no problem with the New Age. I have no problem with the churches. I have no problem with
anything. Anything goes, there's not that unchallenged.
But he runs a moderated forum.
Yeah, well, when it goes unchallenged, that's like saying you agree with it.
I guess he wants everyone in this group to agree with
his
stuff.
That's really the bottom line.
No, he's first off, he has two advocates who's read my stuff and say, hey, there's something here. And he can't deal with them. So I don't have to bother really attacking him or even criticizing him, because he's got two of his own people doing it, two of the major people in it. Mm-hmm. And
what's the law is kind of weaseling in there.
All these people of truth are going to need leaders.
Yeah.
So are you ready to be leaders? Are you ready to say the original, the truth is made up of many voices, many visions? He who leads into captivity is himself led into captivity. Whatever restrictions you impose, somebody wants to be a drug addict, well then let them be a drug addict. Just the problem is right now in the United States is the public schools.
And that's a drug.
Because you're taking the kids away from the parents and you're forcing them into this educational role and you're forcing them to think in a certain way. That's what causes the trouble. Public school system is unconstitutional from a constitutional perspective. Because it tries to homogenize the thinking of the people. And anytime you attempt to homogenize the thinking of the people and say this is what's right, this is what's wrong, you just change yourself. Darwinism, they're still teaching Darwinism, yet modern physics has proven Darwinism to be back with the age technology.
Well, I think what they teach is Darwinism is not what Darwin said anyway.
It's become a religion.
Just like all the others.
It's the holy grail of atheism.
When I listened to these people talk, I saw them as former church leaders, but now they're coming from the opposite perspective of it, but still defending this dogmatic.
When someone says they're a homosexual, the question should be, well, why are you homosexual? Or why are you this? Why are you that? There's a reason, always there's a causal factor. Now, there is cases where a soul chooses a certain life to experience it because they need to experience it, but in a lot of cases, most of the activists and whatnot all were on the opposite side of the coin and abused the very people they're now promoting.
I found the people who promote science very strongly are often do so religiously, and they don't put down anyone who doesn't, who has an intuitive perspective.
Yeah.
I get that a lot in the forum I run. It's they don't want people to have someone that's criticized a review of a product because it didn't have anything scientific in it. It is only on my feeling about this because it feels this way and feels that way. The guy wrote a big rant about how this review would be put on the front page. It's terrible. It's a terrible review. Should be removed. It's like, why? It's just their feeling. Why can't they post their feeling? It's supposed to be a hobby. It's supposed to be fun. Why can't they do it that way?
It's going to be interesting to see what Facebook does now that they've got all these people up in arms. They want to censor this and censor that. They had that Texas cheerleader who went big game hunting, and they thought they got Facebook to take down some of the pictures of the animals.
Then they said it was a technology glitch.
Did they?
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
Yeah.
It's like what's the name? The New York congressman who said, someone hacked into my email and sent all those pictures. Wasn't really me.
Someone posted naked baby pictures and their pictures were deleted. Is it Facebook?
Yeah.
On Instagram. Instagram deleted someone's baby pictures because the baby was naked.
No, they really, because she reenacted the Coppertone commercial.
Yeah, but she was a photographer.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so they just blew it out of proportion.
And they banned her from life from Facebook.
And now, what is it? Oh, the lost emails.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Where other ones are, now they've got the whole trail of her saying how she did that.
Yeah.
Be careful of what you say in email. And is that other inner office thing, is that saved anywhere? Okay, good, all right. And it's like, So they've got a nail on that.
You start talking about like the laws that kind of invoking their opposite. There's the Freedom of Information Act or whatever. And so you'll see that lots of times people involved in government, you know, type things. So you have the Freedom of Information Act, which is designed to allow access mm-hmm. to certain information, but the result is people clam up because mm-hmm. they don't want to be, you know, subpoenaed or whatever. So
it's very interesting working on a military base where I have to go through these trainings every year, these computer trainings about, and I always laugh when I do them because I think nobody in government is following the ethics one. I laugh all the way through it. I mean, the IRS violated every screen that I had to pass to be a teacher. They violated the IRS, you know.
But it's that way in general. I mean, like Congress sets up Social Security for everybody else, but they have their own
yeah.
golden parachute. You get like 100%
this is one of, the,
of your the, salary,
one of the,
even if just after a
one
term.
Of the senators and congressmen is presently suing, and they may have standing because the law says that the congressional support has to live by whatever law they enact for the general people. And Obama wrote an exemption for them. You can say it's against the law. And you would see things different if the elites had to live by the same rules that they set for the peons.
They're all from elite families, and they all get into power.
What do you know? You're an Englishman living in Japan.
I'm an Australian living in Japan. It's the same in Australia. They're all from. They had a temp. They had a equivalent of a senator who had been. No, it was. I remember the guy. He was a complete idiot. He couldn't even speak with it. Every time he opened his mouth.
I mean, there's
he,
more than
because
one,
he was in a family.
I mean, there's more than one Nancy Pelosi.
Oh, there's. They're all the elite families, they all go to the same schools, they all know each other, they all get put into power, even if they're completely stupid, it's the same thing.
How about the anti-gun activist in California that he broke into his house and he shot him dead?
Yeah.
Oh, the anti-gun activist?
There was an anti-gun
activist.
Yes.
Yeah, he shot somebody.
Who broke into his house?
Yes.
He shot him.
But he was... He did. He wanted total no guns. Nobody should have guns.
Except him.
Except him.
Do as they do as they say.
Except him. You know, Bloomberg is the same way.
Yeah.
He, you know, Ted Kennedy used to have security with machine guns following him wherever he went.
Easy for him to impose no weapons
right.
on the populace. He's got people to.
You want the
protect
you want
him.
The what this happens? It makes places like Chicago and
yeah.
the back alleys of Los Angeles,
Detroit.
Where Detroit. That's
yeah, central Detroit. My friend lives in the outskirts and had. Did I tell you the story about how the outskirts of Detroit, the outside is all white, mostly white.
Yes,
and
they drove the
black.
Whites out of Detroit.
And so there's this, he's at his office late one night with his family sitting in the car, and there's this, the wife calls him in the office, there's this car cruising around with four black guys in it. And what should I do? He said, get the heck home, I'll take care of it. And eventually he goes off actually into a far car park where they can't see it, but he, instead of going home, which is very stupid, but the car pulls up in front of his office and he walks out with holding a shotgun by his side and says, can I help you guys? And the guy doesn't let his hands off the steering wheel because he knows that if he takes his hands off the steering wheel, that shotgun's in his face. He says, well, I was looking for a job. He said, well, you should come back during working hours. All right. And drives off. He's holding the shot. He's been trained by the, you know, he was trained, his friend was one of the guys from SEAL Team 6 guys. So he'd been trained in all that stuff. And he was basically, you know, that he was.
You realize that Constantine, the man Constantine, was making the rules of the church. But he wasn't even considered a Christian. And that because at that time, the belief that's the doctrine that's in the Shepherd of Hermas was in effect, that there is no forgiveness once you're baptized if you consciously sin. That's why he carried a priest with him in constant attendance, and he was baptized on his deathbed.
So that he wouldn't have an opportunity to sin
right.
after yeah. being baptized.
Right. But he was prior to that point, when he was not even considered a Christian, he was dictating what Christians were allowed to believe.
Yeah.
Does anything become more convoluted than that? That's like going to Obama to ask him to be leader of your church. Or
he's
Bill Clinton.
Christian.
Or some Muslim, whatever. More questions? Is that it?
Should we have lunch?
Is the soup ready?
Yeah. I've got 9 minutes to go.
Beth, you got any more? Are you satisfied with what I got here?
I think it's very good.
Yeah.
Yep.
We'll see if I stick to it.
Yeah.
Never know how the
we'll all be interested
to get a slide too.
When I got up this morning, I thought of it. But then, you know, this is a different group than I would talk and I can work it all in. I have no problem freelancing. And what came to mind was my thoughts when I first encountered the Ebionites in the past life, and I couldn't understand, coming from our culture, I could not understand for the life of me how all the elders could say sometimes conflicting things, and they were all there.
You know, it reminds me of the last church I belonged to. The minister always used to say, you know, the Episcopal belief is to agree to disagree, but everybody that she disagreed with, or that disagreed with her, she chased off.
Mm-hmm.
And then she would go back and say that again, and I'd be, you know.
I can easily predict.
I'm counting off the people that I've watched since I've been there that she chased off, and I'm thinking,
I can easily portray Jesus as God, since at the core of our being we're all God. And I can easily portray Jesus as a man who became God. Which one is right?
Both.
They're both right.
Right. There's also a truth in between there. That's
mm-hmm.
The devil's always in the details. So is that it? Lunchtime?
Lunchtime.
Lunchtime.